You have to trade, Vinny. What would you trade in non-US market hours? Forex futures or still the main indices? Really, for me, whatever's moving in non-US market hours. So I have a rule of thumb. Let me show you guys this. If you're in our e-mini main chat, you're going to look at our sessions, exclamation mark, sessions, and then for the overnight, sessions two, or session two. You know about the daytime ones, but after hours, here are the things you need to think about if you're going to be trading the non-US market hours, okay? Here's what I say. I do not recommend for new traders to trade the Asian European session US overnight. Now, there's a lot of reasons for that. It tends to be a new trader usually has a smaller account, whatnot, blah, blah, blah. Again, up to you if you want the risk and yada, yada. My suggestions are don't. But if you want to watch it, you want to sim it, you want to practice it, that's fine. Get good at it. But here are some scenarios where you might want to after hours. Here's the scenarios. Bank of Japan reporting. Okay, that's a Red Star News event. Bank of Japan in the off hours. That's a good one. Something that gives some extra volatility in the off hours is going to be good for it. Or any type of macro event, market moving news events. Okay. Typically, another thing, volatility is naturally, you know, it comes in the Asian close. So if it's at the close or the European open, okay, there's like a little time window there. That's why I squared those up here at the 3 a.m. and 6 a.m. Eastern time. Those opens and closes might be a spot, but in general, do you really want to roll through the whole day unless there are, again, market impacting news events where you're going to get that extra volatility because of news. In general, that's my suggestion around dealing with non-US sessions.